Based on its regular economic and monetary analysis, the Governing Council continues to view the current key ECB interest rates as appropriate. It therefore decided to leave them unchanged. Considering all the new information and analysis which have become available since our meeting of the 2nd of September 2010, we continue to expect price developments to remain moderate over the policy-relevant medium-term horizon. Recent economic data are consistent with our expectation that the recovery should proceed at a moderate pace in the second half of this year, with the underlying momentum remaining positive. At the same time, uncertainty is still prevailing. We call all banks to continue, and it is our permanent message, to take all appropriate measures to reinforce their balance sheet, reinforce their capital base, be in line with such appropriate decision. And we also say, when it is needed, that they can and have to ask public authorities, which have already committed themselves to provide appropriate support, to activate this support. Excess volatility and disorderly movements in exchange rates have adverse implications for economic and financial stability. And of course, I would say that I've always appreciated, and you know that because you heard me saying that a number of times, that I share the view of the US authorities when they reiterate that they trust that a strong dollar is in the interest of the United States of America. We met with the Chinese authorities, and I said, as well as you know, because it's been made public already, that it is very important that the exchange rate policy reform announced by China June 19th would be implemented. The use of flexibility offered by this new policy framework is very important and would allow a gradual appreciation of the renminbi, we trust, in effective terms. And we trust also that this, and it's been reaffirmed by the Chinese government, that this decision of the 19th of June was confirmed. This, we trust, is positive for growth in China and for balanced growth at a global level.